Hey, it's Matthew. Let's talk about business strategies. Business strategy is one of the toughest things to teach people. And so we work with a lot of universities around the world, as well as businesses and so on. So we've worked with thousands and thousands of students. And strategy is probably the toughest thing that they try to learn. And the reason is strategy requires an understanding of multiple aspects of business and how they interrelate together. And that interrelation is where things become really challenging, particularly because university education, business education is often taught in almost in a siloed way, right? You learn marketing in a marketing course and accounting in an accounting course and HR in an HR course and so on. And then sometimes there might be a course called strategy or something else that's generally almost they're considered what's called a capstone course where they try to bring everything together. But it's one course after, you know, several years of learning about business. And we see students struggle with this even at the master's level. I'm going to show you how we help students understand what strategy is and how to act on strategy. So what you're looking at here is GoVenture CEO. It's an online head-to-head multiplayer simulation where students run businesses at the very high level. They're not dealing with the day-to-day operations. And then they're competing against their classmates. And so they'd all be running the same type of business, whether they're manufacturing cars or motorcycles or soft drinks or a service business. And they're all running the same type of business going after the same in the same marketplace for the same customers. So you have to differentiate your product in that space. So with that in mind, we have what's called a strategy journal. Okay, so the strategy journal, simple concept, but very powerful in its learning. So what we do with the strategy journal is we take every high-level decision that the student is making in the simulation for their business, and we have a series of drop-downs that you see in these orange boxes, and we have the student identify what their strategy is for that particular item, that metric, this period of the simulation. So the simulation moves in periods. It could be a business week, a business month, a business quarter. So we say, what is your strategy this period? And you can see, for example, our objective. So this is the overall objective. What is our strategy? Is it net profit? Is it revenue? Maybe we're trying to maximize our units because we have extra inventory, or just we want to build our brand and not worry about profit. So what is the overall objective for the period? So I can identify that. And then pricing. What is my pricing strategy? Let's talk example. So let's say we're all manufacturing cars, and we're trying to differentiate our cars in the marketplace. I might take a Mercedes strategy. You know, so Mercedes, a premium brand, products, cars tend to be more expensive than average. Maybe quality, perceived quality at least, and maybe even actual quality can be higher. So I might take that type of strategy compared to another student I'm competing with who might take more of a Kia strategy, right? So Kia, more affordable, more reliable type automobiles. And so if I'm going to take the Mercedes strategy, then what I'm going to identify here is that my pricing should be above average or high compared to my competitors who may be taking a different type of strategy. And so I would identify that here. And then I would continue this for all the things that you see from ethics, R&D, marketing, brand, HR, and targeting my consumer profiles. Now, this choice that I'm making for each of these has no effect on the simulation. What this is doing is putting structure to my thinking for me to understand that all of these things are interrelated and I have to have an objective for all of them. Now here's where the learning really starts to happen. So I identify my strategy here. I then navigate the simulation and make a variety of decisions from production and R&D and marketing and so on. And then the simulation displays my results. It tells me what my sales were, my revenue, my profit, my market share, my employee morale, everything in comparison to the other students I'm competing with. And then what we have is a coaching report. So once the results are determined, we provide the student with a variety of reports. And one of them is called a coaching report where we coach students. And in the coaching report is this table. This table matches the strategy guide that we were looking at a moment ago. So if I switch back here, go back up to the strategy journal guide. So this is the strategy journal. So all these choices here match this table. But what we see differently is we don't have choices anymore. We have icons that represent the current status. And there's three icons: a green icon, which means on target; a yellow icon, which means close to target; and a red icon, which means off target. So what the simulation does is it looks at your objectives that I've entered here. It compares them to the actual results of the simulation, and then gives me an indicator as to whether I'm adhering to my strategy or not. So wherever you see green, it means, hey, Matthew, your objective was this, and you hit it. Wherever you see yellow, it means I was close to my objective, not quite on target, but close. And then red, I'm totally off. So earlier, I gave the example that I wanted to maximize net profit as my goal. And it's telling me, did I maximize net profit? Close, but not exactly on target. Also, pricing. You know, in this example, it shows average. But let's say I had set average in the strategy guide, then it's telling me I hit that target. The reason this is important and very powerful is because this is where we see students fall down all the time, is they don't really understand strategy. We help them with the guide. They look at the results, and then they come back and say, oh, my strategy's not working. I have to change something. When in reality, they weren't actually making decisions that were aligned with their strategy. So they're assessing data in a way that they could never come to proper conclusions because they weren't making decisions consistent with what they wanted to achieve. And so in terms of strategy, the first thing you need to do is identify your objectives, then evaluate results to see if you've aligned with those objectives. So for example, if I had all greens here, or mostly greens and some yellows, then it tells me that I did align with my objective. I made decisions that were aligned with my objectives. Then when I look at the results, then I can really understand, hey, okay, based on these results, is my strategy working? If it is, keep going. If it's not, maybe I need to adjust or pivot. In some cases, I might be completely off target. So I said I want to do this. The results were completely wrong, but my profitability was amazing. But just by luck or circumstance, I actually did well, even though I didn't align with my strategy. And then I might say, well, you know what? This is working, and this is working for me. So I'm going to now change my strategy to match what I did because it's working. And if you think about the history of a lot of businesses, that actually has happened, right? Where a business comes out with a particular product or service, doesn't quite work the way they expected, but they found some pivot or some adjustment or some other market they weren't expecting, and all of a sudden they become a very successful business. So that's what we're teaching here with this very simple concept of a strategy guide. Helps put structure to student thinking. Then they see results. They're guided by this report that helps them understand, are you aligning to your strategy or not? If you are aligning to your strategy, okay, let's look at the data and see what worked and what didn't. If you're not aligning to your strategy, then you make some decisions to adjust based on the data you now have so you can better align to your strategy and see how that works out for you. This is the power of simulation-based learning. You can't achieve this type of thinking, this critical thinking, this data analysis, this evidence-based decision-making in any other way. Even in the real world of running a business, it takes months, weeks, years to actually get data back to make decisions like this. This is why simulation is so amazing for teaching strategy. I'm Matthew Giorgio.
GoVenture is one of the original and most widely used series of educational games and simulations in the world. Discover a better way to teach and learn at GoVenture.net.